If you making money, I could put you on my team. Yeah, 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 I got that hustle and maneuver. Talk the trash, I'll be back, but I'll be with my shooter.
What is my rabbit gang? Today we're going to talk about something that, well, it's pretty crazy actually. How to get major record label funding or marketing dollars without even signing a record deal. You got to think outside the box here, and this is what I help you guys do over here at Smart Rapper. I'm Rob Loveland. You're going to get smarter today. I'm going to teach you a lot of things you may not actually have considered. And if you did consider it, I'm going to show you how to actually do it properly, because so many people have been asking me for this video for a long time. I think it's about time to teach you guys the information. Here's what you're going to learn in this video. Number one, how I've gotten over 10 million streams and views on my music from this trick. Now I have over 40 million total, but this strategy has gotten me over 10 million. Number two, how to get record label deal like money for marketing your music without even signing a deal. Number three, how to create the music and content to get these marketing dollars within only a few hours with examples and proof. Number four, how to guarantee your music gets these streams and views. And number five, how all of this works legally so you feel safe and you feel comfortable and you know that it's okay to do what I'm gonna teach you. I'm gonna cover it all in this video. That's why it may seem like it's a little long, but I gotta give you all the information so you understand it all, right? Watch to the end and you're gonna have a whole new outlook on how to get streams and views on your music with a full breakdown of how to do it. What I'm gonna show you in this video is what I'm doing to actually get tens of thousands of new streams and views across my social media every single week. And it only takes me a couple hours to do it. And in this video, I'm gonna show you the exact process broken down. Easy to understand. Now real quick, let's start with this. As you should know, if you've ever looked at my music or checked out anything of mine, anytime I've ever done a remix to a song, it really got some numbers on it. All but one of them that I've done have gotten over 100,000 views on it. Which means that in general, off of one remix, I tend to get more views on one song than 99% of artists who actually consider themselves a rapper. That means on one song, I'm getting more views and streams than 99% of artists that even call themselves a rapper. Okay, and I've done this more than half a dozen times. And that's just on the remixes. I got 5 million views on Black and Yellow, which when that happened, that's more like 20 million views. Thrift Shops way over 100,000. Headbands over 100,000. Ransoms at almost 1 million. And the I Love It remix, and I showed you guys another video, all the content that I made for it, I pushed it for 2 weeks, it got over 100,000 views on it. Most of these were done in the same day. And before we go any further, I wanna mention this to you guys. If you really consider, look at Lil Wayne. Iconic, top 5 best rapper of all time. It doesn't matter what you're thinking, it's Lil Wayne, I don't care what you're talking about. His career was massively launched and upheld by him doing remixes to popular songs. Look at all of his mixtapes. I'm gonna talk to you about that in a minute and tell you more about why that worked. Now before you write this off as a stupid idea, I'm gonna explain to you 9 massive benefits of you doing remixes to songs, okay? Things that you probably didn't even realize were powerful. Benefit number one, anybody who hears your remix is already 50% more likely to actually like you as an artist. Why? Because 50% of the song is a beat they're already familiar with and they already like. So that helps you really bypass a lot of haters that exist because they already like 50% of the song. You just have to make sure that you make the other 50% of it good enough to like. Benefit number two, because remixes will organically come up in Google and YouTube searches, you can start making remixes to songs of people that you actually sound like. So you can start gaining the fans really targeted, okay? This means you're gonna gain what's considered organic clicks to your music on a regular basis. It means you're not gonna spend any money. The people are just gonna come flooding in if you do what I teach you in this video. Now this is because when somebody types in the name of a bigger artist, you just happen to be right next to that artist as soon as they search it, and then they go, what's this? It's a remix, and they click it, and then they see you. Look at how many searches an artist's name gets on Google monthly. Drake gets 1.2 million searches on his name a month, okay? DaBaby gets almost 1 million combined with his name being Googled and spelled wrong, okay? And Lil Baby gets almost 400,000 searches on Google, okay? Now take into account, those are Google searches. That doesn't account as how many times they get searched on YouTube. It's even higher. Did you know that? Did you even know that? Benefit to you number three. So what does this all mean? It means that these artists are getting organic searches, millions a month, okay? Record labels spent millions of dollars to get these artists to the level where they're that searchable and have that much traction. Additionally, every time a label drops a single, they put hundreds of thousands of dollars into that single for that artist and the name of that artist and the title of the song for that artist, okay? A song that drives millions of people a month to that song search. Those same searches trickle down to your remix if you do it on the teach it in this video. This is how you're gonna get hundreds of thousands of dollars from the label for their marketing straight to you. Cause boom, their video's there, they're spending hundreds of thousands of dollars marketing. You do it right and you're on that first page. You're right there to get those searches. How do you think I was capable of consistently ranking for doing remixes and getting people to listen and gain all those fans? You're getting hundreds of thousands of dollars in marketing without spending a single dime of your own money. Most artists never think about it like this. But this is why remixing a song is so valuable. It's worth a lot of money for your brand. A lot more money than you definitely have spent so far. Benefit number four, you can remix as many songs as you want, as often as you want. Just follow what I'm gonna tell you in this video. Benefit number five, you have to build momentum. You've heard me say that a million times. What better way to keep fans entertained than to remix a song they already like, and then at the same time, you're dropping your original music too? Think about that. Benefit to you number six, weekly releases or doing these remixes on a regular basis shows the world that you're actually an artist. Because it's not you dropping one song every month or every 2 months, it's you on a regular basis dropping your original music and then also dropping remixes, slaughtering the beat, showing how versatile you are, showing how good you are. Think about that. Benefit to you number seven, you get to show off your music style on a different type of beat, okay? And let's go into number eight, which is you actually get to practice your music style, your versatility, and building your skill set on somebody else's beat, okay? Do you know how much better you're gonna be at rapping if you're doing this on a regular basis? This is amazing practice. Now, benefit to you number nine, let's consider Lil Wayne's career. All those mixtapes were all remixes, and he's infamous for those. He took the top songs of the year that he already knew that people already loved because it had already been proven that these people love these songs. I'm gonna remix these. And then he just put bars on them. He just put bars on them. He didn't even have to make hooks for them. He just rapped on them. Hook's the hardest part. Think about that. This allowed Lil Wayne to stay ultra relevant on a regular basis. And at the same time, while able to sit on his hottest songs. He didn't have to put his hottest songs on a mixtape. No, he sat on his hottest songs, released the remixes as extra songs with his extra bars on them, okay? And then he started releasing his singles, okay? That's genius. And that's how you could do it. You could just release a bunch of remixes. You don't have to release original stuff and you'll grow. And then people will be begging you for original music. So without further ado, here's the formula me and my team are currently using to do remixes, grow them, and also next we're gonna talk about how to get into search and how to make sure people are actually gonna see your stuff, okay? This is awesome. And then we're gonna talk about the legal stuff, because you're like, oh, how do I do a remix? How am I allowed to use the beat? We're gonna talk about all that. I'm gonna teach you. So I had to bring out the whiteboard, because this is serious. I'm gonna show you the step-by-step thing to do here, okay? And this is very easy. Just follow along the process, you'll be able to do this. And what's beautiful is, me and my team are able to make remixes to songs in less than 30 minutes, okay? Seriously, less than 30 minutes. And we're talking about including making the beat, but we're also seasoned at this. We've been doing this a long time. All right, number one is, You simply choose the most valuable, the most popular song out right now that you like, that you can remix, that makes sense for you and your style. The more recently that it's been released, the better, because people are still spreading it person to person, and it's going to be able to get you into the search, and you're gonna be able to rank before somebody else. You wait too long, other people are doing remixes, other people are gonna rank, the YouTube algorithm is gonna say, these are great for the search, this is what people are looking for, and you're gonna be cut out. So you have to do this as soon as the song releases, otherwise it's a lot harder to rank, trust me. When I wrote and recorded my verse to I Love It, I also shot the music video same day, that song was out the same day. I was the third search for a long time, okay? 100,000 streams, that's organic, free publicity, free marketing from Kanye West and Lil Pump. Everybody on the song. Love it or hate it, didn't care. It was exposure to my brand. If I'd done that every single week, it would have went from 100,000 to 200,000, then it would have kept growing. It's just a lot of upkeep, right? But that's what I'm doing now, because now I have a process. Now I have all the singles. Now I have the marketing budget. Now I have everything lined up for my success. And that's why I'm showing you that I'm doing it, so you guys can do it too. Number two, very simple. After you choose a song, go get the beat for it. What's beautiful is beat makers are doing the same thing we're doing here, because they want to get the search traffic when people search for the instrumental for a song. So as soon as NBA Youngboy or anybody comes out with a new song, that instrumental is already up within a couple hours. So what do? You go get that beat, you go get that instrumental immediately, download it. Now there's a little bit, now it's something a little different that I don't actually use the beat, because I don't own the beat, I can't monetize it. Also, you guys would actually be doing an exact remix. Me, my producer comes in here and he remakes the beat in like 10 minutes. But he doesn't remake that beat. He makes a unique beat based on the sound of that beat. So it's actually a remix slash remake that I can still monetize. I can still put on Spotify and it sounds different and it sounds cool. But lucky for you, you get to skip this entire process by just going and grabbing the beat from another producer who put it on YouTube. And trust me, go through a couple different instrumentals from different producers. Some people remake it a lot better than other people. Trust me. Number three, duh, you got the beat now. Write your verses, write your lyrics. What I do is this. I write my verses like this, a 12, 16 bar verse. And my creative director, Sutton, if you were part of the Rapper Shortcut, anybody knows, I have a lead degree from Columbia, New York. She's my creative director. She used to work at Disney, stuff like that. She is also
a classically trained singer. So what we do is we take the rap hook or whatever song it is and she sings it instead of raps it. That adds another little element that's interesting when somebody watches it as a remix, okay? Beats change, the hook's different, and then I'm rapping on it with a different verse. It's a different, interesting mix-up. It's a completely remade song, but it's fun, and that's how we're gonna gain a lot of fans. Because it's unexpected, but it's really good. You can take the song and put your own spin on it as well. You know, maybe you slow down the beat, you change it a little bit, do different things, put your creative spin on it. Be unique. Stand out, all right? Number four, and in just a second, I'm gonna tell you how you're gonna be able to rank your remix in Google and in YouTube, okay? So stick around for that. That's like probably the most important part of this whole thing. But number four is the video, because in order to rank, you have to create something that's visually stimulating and entertaining because, well, I'll tell you in a second. So what me and my team did is, while we were actually creating this in that 30 minutes, we just shot video of us recording it. We shot footage of him making the beat, shot footage of her singing, and we shot the footage of me recording it live, one take, boom, did it, done. Then we edited that video together, and it's organic, and it looks fantastic. But here's the thing. You're like, Rob, I can't shoot a video of this. I don't have a camera. I shot it on my phone. Shut up. Shot it on my phone. You can too. I didn't do any color correction to it. I just edited it and I put it out. It made it look organic. I'll put a link to some of these videos so that you can actually see what they look like. It actually took me more time to edit the video than it did to actually write and record the song. Mixing the song took longer than it took to record the song. But it shows us having fun in the studio and it brings every viewer into our world, okay? And that's why this is actually a very important part of it. Now, if you're gonna say that you don't know how to edit music videos, again, shut up. It's so easy to do. And if you don't know how, I actually have an entire course that teaches you how to shoot music videos with your phone, framing, angles, color correction, everything, with $0 budgets, how to actually do that, okay? So if you wanna get that, you go to smartrapper.com/musicvideos and it'll bring you right over to that course. Nope, it's not free. Nope, it's not cheap. Yes, you'll be able to shoot it at all your music videos for the next couple years in your career until you blow up and can hire somebody else. That's the point. That's why I taught myself how to do all this. I edited over 2,000 videos by myself for Smart Rapper. I also edited a bunch of my music videos. It's not that hard. You'll get the hang of it. It teaches you everything you need to know. Now, quick tip here, even if you feel like, oh man, shooting that video, I'm new to that, I don't know how to do that, I don't shoot the video, you need to at least have a lyric video. Okay, and the reason you want a lyric video is because you need as much visual stimulation as possible to keep the person watching as long as possible. And that's what we're gonna talk about when I start talking about the ranking, okay? Which I'm gonna do next, all right? And I also have a lyric video course. So if you go to smartrapper.com/lyric videos, you will be able to get a course that's really not that expensive at all that teaches you how to make lyric videos in less than an hour, and also how to make lyric videos for other artists and sell them to them to make money from artists, as well as scripts on what to say to artists and how to find artists to sell lyric videos to. That's an entire business model, and I show you everything how to do that. That is a massively loved course that I have on Smart Rapper. Again, I put the link below or smartrapper.com/lyric videos. Now, just so you can see kind of what I'm talking about with a quick video that really was so simple, just organically shot in here that we edited it up. I'm gonna play it on the screen. It was shot with my phone, okay? And I have an Android, so okay? Seriously, super easy. Here it is. I'm gonna play like a 20-second snippet of the song with the video so you can see it, okay?
Holy moly, you're fighting me like a dolly. You pull up and you let your body tell me cuss, what up cuss. Holy moly, you're fighting me like a dolly. Pull up and you let your body tell me cuss.
Never wanna talk to me ever, but level leveled up and then he leveled up his leverage. How to shoot my shot message, so far 90% out free throw percentage. Use cop knock off nights for gays. 50 each by 2, get amazing. Saving money, man, the deal too crazy. Had 2 jobs and they both barely paid me.
See, look at that, on a phone, come on, less than 30 minutes, come on. Easy, you could do that, you could easily do that. Every week, shut up. Every time I talk about it, you can do that. Now let's talk about how to get your stuff to rank in Google and YouTube. Now the first factor that's important is that people actually click your video. Duh, right? That's why the thumbnail and the title is so important. The next most important factor of anything is how long they watch your video, okay? If they turn it on and turn it off within 20 seconds, no bueno. This tells YouTube this was not the video people were searching for, and therefore it kicks you further down in the rank search. You won't be on the front page because Google thinks that when you type, they type in the artist's name, you're not gonna pop up in any of the positions because it's thinking that, according to the algorithm, other people are not watching this. So when they type that name and they click that's not what they're searching for and this is not good content. But if they're watching it all the way through, YouTube's saying, damn, they watched this whole video for 2-3 minutes? Okay, this is probably something valuable, okay? Especially if they're engaging in more. This is how all the algorithms work. And this is why we shoot a music video for it. It keeps the person entertained to keep watching along with the audience. What? If they like the song, they'll definitely watch the video to the end, right? And that tells YouTube, people are watching this whole video, let's put it in the rank in the search and let's see how people actually deal with it. They're clearly watching it for a while. And you'll also notice inside of that video snippet that included the lyrics that were happening in the song. So it actually combined a lyric video with a music video. Like that. So they didn't need to go find the lyrics anywhere. They're right there on the screen. Of course, they still put them on Genius and everything, but it's a lyric video and a music video to keep them ultra stimulated. With this combination, it massively increases my chances to rank. I haven't really looked since the first day, but that video was the third search when you typed in that video title. Now let's talk about legally how you using another person's beat actually works on YouTube, okay? People always ask me if they're allowed to use a beat for another song, okay? The answer is yes. But are you allowed to make money from the song, from the remix that you make? That answer is no. You notice rappers like JID and IDK and all the other acronyms and other artists like that and my boy Dax and other rappers are actually remixing songs on a regular basis. This is part of the reason why they're doing it. It's exposure and content. So you're clearly allowed to do it, right? Now, are you allowed to put a song remix on a Spotify, Apple Music, and everything else with that beat? That answer is no. But you could, realistically. Unless your huge label isn't gonna like really concern themselves with you. They're not really gonna bother with you making a tiny amount of money off the song. Just saying, I'm not saying you should do that, I'm just saying that you probably could and you could get away with it until you blew up. I didn't even upload them. It's fans of mine were uploading my remixes just so they had them on the platform and those were getting streams. There you guys go. Make sure you subscribe for me. 3 new videos a week. Tons of videos, content. I have so many new videos you guys are gonna absolutely love. Make sure you're checking out my remixes. Make sure you check out my original music. Make sure you're seeing these marketing plans and strategies that I'm putting in front of you on Smart Rapper. Make sure that you're checking out the Rapper Shortcut so you can have the shortcut to success. Make sure you're checking out all the other courses I have. Make sure you're just checking this stuff out, man. It's the year, I'm telling you all. Links to the music video course and the lyric video course below. Right. Links to the Rapper Shortcut in the calendar below. Links to my music, my Instagrams are below. Rob_Level@SmartRapper. New content on there. New, unique content that's not on YouTube so you guys can learn further there, as well as inspirational content to keep you going. And I'm exploding on Spotify. All my stuff's going right into the algorithm. You guys want to check it out? I stay over 50,000 monthly listeners, and I guarantee you it's going to be over 1 million monthly listeners by the end of 2020. All right? So keep following my footsteps. Keep watching these videos and subscribe. Hit that little bell when you do. Like this video. Comment below. All right? If I helps you out, comments help me as well. All right? So keep hustling, gang. I don't stop. I'll see you at the top.
If you making money, I could put you on my team. Yeah. I got that hustle and maneuver. Talk that trash, I'll be back, but I'll be with my shooter. My pinky scratch, don't want that, I drop out from the Uber. Dip and dash, hit the pad, burn like Freddy Krueger.